Einstein is considered as the biggest scientific genius of all time. He's everywhere. You probably know about E equals MC squared, his most famous equation. You've probably seen his picture with his tongue out and how he said you can judge a fish from its ability to climb a tree, which he undoubtedly, at some point in history, really said. No doubt about that. Among many other things, he definitely had said. But there's no wonder why he's very celebrated. No other person in history contributed more to human knowledge than Albert Einstein, from E equals MC squared, to special relativity, to Brownian motion, and to general relativity. His biggest achievement, that single-handedly threw Newtonian physics that had dominated physics for more than 200 years. He is one of the pioneers of the quantum revolution after Max Planck and Niels Bohr, when he demonstrated the photoelectric effect, and he contributed considerably when he thought quantum physics was incomplete. He proposed a thought experiment called Einstein-Podolsky-Rosen paradox, and he hated the uncertain nature of the quantum world. He arguably invented the idea of wormholes through the Einstein-Rosen bridge. Not only that, his general theory of relativity also remains undefeated in all tests even 100 years after its genesis. He was legendary. He even strived to search for a unified field theory, something scientists are trying to find now, better known as the theory of everything, before he died, which he didn't have the opportunity to finish. He contributed substantially to human knowledge, but what would happen if he never existed? Well, while some would say that we won't be able to enjoy the luxuries of modern life that used the theory of relativity as a part of their existence, like the GPS, television, phones, or also other big things, like the study of black holes, the structure and the evolution of the universe, and the Big Bang, the general consensus would say that every one of his discoveries would still have occurred anyway. There are other scientists who are able to produce theories resembling general relativity. They may not think like Einstein, and there may be other ways things could have evolved, and it would even take decades longer, but we still would have discovered it anyway. In the 1880s, J.J. Thomson began to think that electric and magnetic fields of moving charged particles must carry energy with them. He tried to quantify the amount of that energy. It allowed Oliver Heaviside to determine the effective mass of a charged particle that was proportional to the electric field energy divided by the speed of light squared. Henri Poincaré independently derived E equals MC squared in 1900, but didn't understand the implications of his derivations. So even without Einstein, we were already precariously close to discovering the most famous equation. It's the same with special relativity. The Michelson-Morley experiment demonstrated that the speed of light was always constant. Hendrik Lorentz had already uncovered equations that determined how velocity is added and how time dilated, and George Fitzgerald independently determined how lengths contracted in the direction of motion. These were the very ingredients of special relativity. However, it was Einstein who put it together, but it's still unrealistic to imagine that those two wouldn't arrive at the same conclusion. So even without Einstein, we were already so close. Max Planck discovered Planck's constant, and his theory says that light is absorbed and emitted as quanta or particles, not waves. But it was Einstein who explained the photoelectric effect using Planck's theory. Still, it would have happened with or without Einstein. Quantum mechanics are also thought to have developed just as well without Einstein, but the biggest one is general relativity. According to Einstein, compared with general relativity, special relativity was mere child's play because of how hard gravity was. But with the achievement of special relativity, he's now expanding the theory by adding acceleration to it. He realized that gravity causes acceleration. He also said that the effects of gravity and acceleration were indistinguishable, calling it the equivalence principle. He said it was the happiest thought of his life, leaving him with temporary insomnia for 3 days. Yeah. But other people could also have made that same discovery. Poincaré applied special relativity to the orbit of Mercury, which Einstein also did. Hermann Minkowski, Einstein's former professor, formulated the idea that space and time were from the same fabric. And perhaps the most fascinating one was David Hilbert, who was also playing with non-Euclidean geometry and formulated the same action principle as Einstein that led Einstein to the field equations, even though Hilbert didn't exactly get it right. Despite that, we still call it Einstein-Hilbert action today. Out of all advances that Einstein had made, this was his biggest discovery, his crowning achievement, This was the one his peers were farthest behind when he put it forward. But still, it might have even taken years or even decades. But the fact that others were thinking along the same lines made us think that even without Einstein, the discovery would have fallen into the lap of human knowledge eventually. We like to think that without that one individual, that genius, we would have never gained the remarkable knowledge that we have today. But when we look back in history, we see many others were also close to a discovery just before it was made. Alexis Jarubinsky pieces together inflation before Alan Guth did. Georges Lemaître and Howard Robertson put together the expanding universe before Hubble did. And Shinichiro Tomonaga worked out the calculations of quantum electrodynamics before Julian Schwinger and Richard Feynman did. Newton and Leibniz independently invented calculus, even though Leibniz was a bit late because he didn't publish his work for 20 years. But now, we use his superior differential notation more instead of Newton's fraction notation. So, the same thing with them. If Newton didn't exist, Leibniz would have discovered it, and the other way around. It's a matter of fast or slow. It is said that things are not invented, but discovered. Does that mean that anyone can discover it? Can we all solve really hard problems? Well, Stephen Hawking thought so. He said, if people are curious enough, they would eventually discover it. It got me thinking about something I had seen a few years prior, called the Full Potential Challenge, where you do everything right to fulfill your potential, from the moment you wake up to the moment you go to bed. What would happen if you did everything right? Would you be in a different place from where you are right now? Imagine if everyone reached their full potential. Would the world be vastly different? Or, if we're being pessimistic, do you think the world would be a lot worse if it didn't reach our potential? It's very hard to answer because you can just go back in time and tweak the past to see what will happen. But if it's true, think about the opportunities that we might have lost. What would happen if Einstein didn't refuse his treatment to prolong his life? What would happen if Leonardo da Vinci published his works instead of keeping it all to himself? How many scientists are there lurking in the shadows of our society that are waiting to unleash their discoveries? How many of them are rejected? How many of them don't get to fulfill their full potential because they died before reaching their time? Are you yourself capable of being a great scientist, but you're just raised differently or not in the right moment at the right time? It's all very hypothetical to think about. I think even with Einstein, luck played a role in what we have today. He almost died during his field trip in the Swiss Alps. The world was on fire with the world wars. His existence was threatened by the Nazis and many other things, as is what happened with many other people in history. When we look back at our history, we realize that the world could be a lot better, but it also could be a lot worse. So instead of focusing on the negative, let's focus on the positive, since we can change the past, and we have the power to change the present. Our world also had a lot of close calls. We prevented a lot of potential war, and World War III is still not written in history textbooks, at least not at the time of writing. So, about the Full Potential Challenge, a few years ago, I randomly found this challenge where you try to do everything right for the day. You wake up at the right time, eat the right food, drink enough water, you exercise, you take care of your skin, your body, and everything. The thought of doing all those things seems so thrilling. It's the perfect routine for perfectionists who strive to be perfect in every sense. But it can also get depressing, thinking that you could have been in a better situation had you practiced all those things. But it's hard. And the routine is just not realistic to do every day. There are days when you feel like you're not doing enough, watching too many shows on Netflix, didn't socialize enough, not eating the right food. And sometimes, it can get so bad, like those days when your crush doesn't like you back and you're crying in your bed eating ice cream. Not talking from personal experiences, of course. But yeah, we can change the past. And the only thing we can do is to try to the best of our abilities at the present moment to shape the future to our desired shape. We have to create some wiggle room for error because it's very human to mess up. Leonardo was one of the greatest geniuses of all time, but he struggled with unfinished works. Einstein died without finishing his grand unified field theory, and you yourself are still here despite all the messiness of life that happened to you. So we can think all we want about whether it would be better if Einstein was with us or not, but from what we can see before, we would eventually find our way. Genius is maybe not as rare or unique as we often made it to be. With a lot of hard work and a little luck, any properly trained scientist can make a revolutionary breakthrough simply by stumbling upon discovery at the right place and at the right time. And it doesn't matter anyway to think about that. I love Einstein, and he did exist, and a lot of things exist because of him. The world could have been better, but it's also good enough and we have the power to make it better. And sometimes, that's all we need. So cliche, but whatever. I don't know how to end it, and I believe in that. Thank you.